A senior IRS official has apologized to Congress for wasting taxpayer dollars at an employee conference. The IRS spent over $4 million at a training event in Anaheim, California, 3 years ago. The perks included tickets to Los Angeles baseball games and $64,000 worth of gifts for attendees. They also spent $50,000 to produce a Star Trek video and another video of IRS agents dancing. The House Oversight Committee Chairman Daryl Issa called the spending maliciously self-indulgent. The IRS official who played Spock in the Star Trek video faced the wrath of Congress Thursday.
I have looked at that video over and over again, and I swear I do not see the redeeming value.
What were you thinking? Were you thinking this will never be seen?
Frankly, they were not appropriate at that time neither, Mr. Chairman. And the fact of the matter is it's embarrassing, and I apologize.
The IRS spent $49 million on 225 employee conferences over the past 3 years.
Joining us now with more is Terry Jeffrey, editor-in-chief for CNSNews.com, which has been investigating the IRS scandals. Terry, let's start with this shocking waste, possibly millions of dollars wasted by the IRS at these conventions. What have you uncovered?
Well, they had 49 conventions at places around the country for IRS employees, including, for example, four that were at Las Vegas casinos. They had two at Caesar's Palace, one at New York, and another at the Mandalay Bay Resort Casino in Las Vegas. They had another conference in Anaheim where they rented out three hotels. One was the Hilton right across the street from Disneyland. One of the deputy commissioners of the IRS spent 5 days in the presidential suite of the Hilton across from Disneyland at the expense of the U.S. taxpayers.
All shocking. How on earth, with us facing a massive debt problem, did these conferences get approved?
It's really unbelievable. It just shows you a culture of contempt that bureaucrats in the IRS have for the American taxpayer. I mean, you think about it, going out to Disneyland, they literally brought thousands of IRS employees to that convention during a time when the U.S. economy was struggling, and thinking that this is a legitimate expenditure of government funds. It ought to be inconceivable, but this did in fact happen. Or even going to Las Vegas at all and spending taxpayer money, let alone at these posh resort casinos. It's really extraordinary.
Indeed it is. On another scandal, information is trickling out about Washington officials who oversaw the Tea Party targeting. Does that tell you this was an attempt to influence the 2012 election?
Well, we had a remarkable development. I think clearly when they targeted conservative and Tea Party groups, which we know that they did, and they did it in the 2010 election cycle, it continued into the 2012 election cycle, you have to believe that the people who were doing this had a political animus. But we won't know for sure until we actually know the names of those folks and they come forward and they testify and they tell us what they were doing, why they were doing it, and who told them to do it.
Terry, we heard some powerful testimony this week from conservative groups on Capitol Hill. What was the most disturbing thing they said to you?
Well, I think the most disturbing thing is that these groups clearly were intimidated. When they got inquiries back from the IRS asking them for detailed information, including the names of their donors, the resumes of their employees, the past political activities of their employees, even the potential future contemplated political activities of their employees, not only were people in these groups intimidated, but clearly the folks at the IRS who were asking those questions and overseeing the asking of those questions knew that they were intimidating people who had a political conservative point of view.
Congress is investigating, but is the IRS cooperating?
Well, no, not so far. And there's a major development that's happened. The House Ways and Means Committee, bipartisan way, sent a letter to the IRS demanding answers to 13 questions, including all the records of communications between the IRS and the White House and the IRS and the Treasury on the targeting of conservative groups. This week, the IRS sent back a letter. They said they have 646 gigabytes of documents. They said there's 100,000 pages in each gigabyte. So we're talking about 64.6 million documents the IRS claims it's going to sift through to try and find the responsive documents. And they're not saying they're necessarily going to hand those over. They claim it might be illegal to hand some of those documents over. And they also suggest that because there's a Justice Department investigation and an Inspector General investigation, maybe the answers will come from there. So I think there's still very much a question of whether the IRS is actually going to respond to the congressional committee that has oversight over it and provide it documents that demonstrate what communications there were or there were not with people in the White House about this.
All right, Terry Jeffrey, CNSNews.com. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.